Hey there, Jimmy. What are you up to?
Well, golly, mister. I'm just wildcatting for oil like my grandpappy did, but I can't find any.
That's because we found most of it already, Jimmy.
I drink your milkshake. I drink it up!
Nowadays, we just import most of our oil from Saudi oil barons and Latin American dictators who would never, ever wish us any harm.
Well, we need more energy. Where are we going to get it?
Just look up in the sky, Jimmy. There's more energy there than we could ever need.
Hallelujah!
But how do we get that energy from the sun? We just can't drill it and lay a pipeline to it.
Of course not, you representative of today's youth. It's actually much easier, Jimmy. You see, the sun's rays are made of photons, which, when you run them through a special photovoltaic grid, turn these photons into electrons, which make...
electricity? Then we can power all sorts of things.
We sure can, Jimmy. And since solar cells can't fit in your radio flyer, it makes sense to manufacture them near where you use them. That means right here in Texas. Let's ask this factory owner what he thinks.
Texas is full of investors that are entrepreneur-friendly and full of people who are not afraid to work hard. The people of Texas need to realize that although solar is expensive now, its cost is going to come down dramatically. And if we don't take the opportunity to expand the market in this state while that cost is coming down, we'll be sending our dollars to California instead of the other way around.
That's right, and he should know. He's a captain of industry. By setting a goal of just 2,000 megawatts of solar by 2020, the equivalent of solar panels on just 500,000 rooftops, we could create more than 21,000 jobs, 12,000 of those from manufacturing. How about those green jobs, fellas? But if we want to attract manufacturing here, we need to set a large enough goal to show that Texas is serious about solar. Why, even our president is focusing on solar.
We will harness the sun.
And so you see, Jimmy, solar really is the energy of the future. Now.
But my friend Smokey Joe, who works for the coal company, said that solar's too expensive. Is he crazy?
No, just ignorant. See, unlike coal, natural gas, and nuclear power, whose prices have increased over the past 10 years, the price of solar keeps going down, down, down.
But grid operators say that solar's unreliable.
When Texas gets its energy from wind power, it's most productive at times when people are using less energy. Solar, on the other hand, generates more power the more the sun shines.
Do you mean on a hot summer day when we need lots of energy?
That same sun that makes it too hot to play ball outside is the same sun that will power your air conditioner to cool you off, or keep your ice cream cold in the freezer.
Well, golly, that's swell. But mister, don't we get all of our energy from nuclear and fossil fuels already? Why don't we just keep on doing what we're doing?
Jimmy, if I weren't a disembodied voice, I'd smack you, because that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard you say. Like it or not, Uncle Sam in Washington is going to put a cap on that coal plant's carbon emissions. And then Daddy Coal won't just be the most polluting form of energy, it will be the most expensive, too.
So start building solar and stop building coal.
That's thinking with the old noodle, Jimmy. Solar is carbon-free and doesn't have to pay for fuel after it's up and running. All it needs is that sweet, sweet sunshine Mother Nature gives us for free. So, whether you want to cut your carbon footprint, bring new jobs to Texas, make your home more energy efficient, or just replace polluting power plants, you should think about solar, the energy of the future, today, for a better tomorrow.
The sun is a mass of incandescent gas, a gigantic nuclear furnace, where hydrogen is built into helium at a temperature of millions of degrees.
The sun is hot, the sun is not a place where we could live, but here on Earth there'd be no life without the light it gives. We need its light, we need its heat, the sunlight.